couple of years ago, I was invited to speak in the keynote session of the National Conference of the Council for Christian Colleges and Universities in Washington. On stage were the presidents of each religion's leading faith-based universities. The topic was the place of religion in our country. And I was surprised to hear my fellow panelists bemoan the challenges that faith leaders faced in our contemporary times. When it was my turn to speak, I thought of my many conversations with Rabbi Sacks, which informed and shaped my worldview. From our perspective, I explained, we live in a time of enormous opportunity. The Jewish people have endured an exile lasting thousands of years. And while in the past our goal was simply to persevere, today we have the opportunity to influence and inspire. And this is one of the core lessons Rabbi Sacks impressed upon me, that today there's a dual mission for our people, to protect and to project. For centuries, the goal of the Jewish people was simply to protect. From internal and external forces, we carefully protected our tradition by passing it down to the next generation and protected our children from outside threats and dangers. Jews, especially throughout our exile, focused their efforts and positions of influence to ensure survival. Now, however, we live in an era that is miraculous and wondrous. While the challenges of protecting have not ceased, a whole new vista of opportunities exist. The Jewish people are no longer lost in exile, but have once again returned to their homeland. Torah study is open and accessible throughout the world, where once we might have looked at our neighbors and saw only persecutors. Today we may look at them and see potential partners. While previous generations exclusively protected, Rabbi Sacks projected. He showed us what it means for Jews to carry our beliefs and traditions with confidence and fulfill our sacred mission to spread God's values to the world. As expressed so powerfully by the Hanukkah lights lit inside the Jewish home, our candles brighten the darkness for all. For Rabbi Sacks, the whole notion of an internal-external duality was a false dichotomy, for the dynamic is cyclical and mutually enhancing. Rabbi Sacks was a trailblazer in realizing the possibilities of our moment in history. He was a Jewish leader and thinker of historic proportions, but he was also my teacher and was deeply influential in my religious development and especially in my thinking about Yeshiva University's mission and purpose. When I became president, he called me to encourage me. YU, as the institutional embodiment of his worldview and philosophy, had a special place in his heart. He believed in our students and believed in their capacity to fulfill the sacred mission he so passionately articulated and exemplified. And our students loved him. They loved studying by him when he taught here and were inspired by him in his regular visits to our campus. And it is the consciousness of this sacred mission that elevates all of our day-to-day activities and interactions, whether it be with family, neighbors, or coworkers. From cubicles to corner offices, from Bate Midrash to Zoom rooms and boardrooms and classrooms, inside your own home or in a panel discussion with presidents of faith-based universities, to protect and to project. The mission and responsibility of each Jew is to embody and forward our values to our family, our community, and all those around us. This is how we redeem a fractured world. One cannot say enough of Rabbi Sacks' brilliance, erudition, and oratory mastery. His profound Torah insights on morality and humanity speak for themselves. For me, however, his lasting impact is the insight he inspired within us about ourselves. Lord, we know what we are, Ophelia famously declared, but know not what we may be. Lord Sacks showed us what we may become. And for that, we remain forever inspired and forever grateful. May his memory be for a blessing.